will do some more questions related to AP only. So first question is, if mth term of an AP is 1 by n, mth term of an AP. So what is given in the question? Mth term. So term is denoted by am. So it is given am is equal to 1 by n and the nth term is 1 by m. It is given nth term is equal to 1 by n. Then we have to prove sum of mn terms is half into inside the bracket mn plus 1. So from these two information we will calculate what is the value of a and d. Am, what was the formula? Yes, a plus m minus 1 into d is equal to what is given? 1 by n. And second, an is equal to 1 by n. An is equal to 1 by m. So from there what we will get? A plus n minus 1 into d is equal to 1 by m. Now what we will do with these two equations? Yes, we will do subtraction. Minus, minus, and here also it will be negative. So a and minus a will get cancel there. Remaining here, d is common in both. So I am taking d common. Inside the bracket, what will remain? M minus 1. And here minus sign is there. So that minus sign will get multiplied inside. So it will be equal to minus n minus into minus plus 1 is equal to. Here we will get 1 by n minus 1 by m. Minus 1 and plus 1 will get cancelled. We will get d into m minus n is equal to. Here we will do the cross multiplication. So we will get m minus n by mn. Correct? Now what will come? If we will shift this m minus n to right hand side, m minus n by, here it is in denominator, numerator. So when you will change the position, it will go to denominator. So m minus n and m minus n will get cancelled. So value of d is equal to 1 by mn. So we got the value of d. Now to get the value of a, we will substitute in any one of the equations. So suppose I am substituting in the first one. Here I will write here d is equal to 1 by mn we got. Now am is equal to 1 by n was given. Am, that is a plus m minus 1 into d is equal to 1 by mn given. Now we will substitute the value of d. That is 1 by mn is equal to 1 by mn. 1 by mn not here. Am is equal to 1 by n. Here we will multiply it inside. So a plus m will be multiplied by m by nn, mn. Then minus n by mn is equal to 1 by n. Here these two will get cancelled. Here m minus 1 it is. So here we will get 1 by mn. So we are getting a plus 1 by n minus 1 by mn is equal to 1 by n. So 1 by n and 1 by n will get cancelled. We will get a is equal to 1 by mn. So we got d also is equal to 1 by mn and a also is equal to 1 by mn. A is equal to 1 by mn. Now what we have to prove? We have to prove sum of mn terms. As we are writing sum of n terms as sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So in the same way, now we have to find out sum of mn terms. So what we will write is mn is equal to, in place of n we have to substitute mn. So we will get mn by 2 into 2a. Our value of a was 1 by mn plus, in place of n we have mn minus 1 into d, that is 1 by mn. So we will get mn by 2 into 2 by mn plus mn by mn minus 1 will get multiplied. So, minus 1 by mn. Now, here we will check how we have to arrange there. Mn denominators are same. So, directly we can add the numerator. So, what will come? Mn by 2 into 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. So, 1 plus mn by mn. Now, here these two mn we cannot cancel because here addition sign is there. But here mn is multiplied. So, we can cancel this mn. So, what we got, what we have to prove? Half into mn plus 1. So, it is equal to half into mn plus 1. So, hope the method is clear to you. Clear? Okay. So, now we will move to the next question. The next question, you all please read the question. It is written, sum of n, 2n and 3n terms are S1, S2 and S3. So, first we can write down what are the things given. Sum of n terms they have denoted as S1. So, S1 is sum of n terms. So, directly we are writing S1 is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. That is S1. And then S2 is sum of 2n terms. So, S2 will be equal to 2n by 2 into 2a plus 2n minus 1 into d, S2. And S3 is equal to sum of 3n terms. So, S3 is equal to 3n by 2 into 2a plus 3n minus 1 into d. So, S1, S2 and S3 we wrote. Now, what we have to prove? We have to prove S3 is equal to 3 into S2 minus S1. So, what we will do? We will simplify the right hand side and we will prove that is equal to S3. So, all of you write down here. Right hand side is equal to, in the right hand side it is written 3 into S2 minus S1. So, now what we are going to do? We are going to substitute the values. 3 into S2 is 2n by 2 into 2a plus 2n minus 1 into d minus S1 is n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. At present, I did nothing. I wrote what we have to prove. I wrote the right hand side and then substituted the value. Now, we will simplify it. So, before simplification, we can check. If any common factor is there, we can take the common factor outside. Here, just to check, n by 2 common in both. So, n by 2 I am taking common. So, 3 into n by 2 I took common. 3. Already it was there. N by 2 I took common. So, remaining what here? 2. So, that 2 will get multiplied here. So, 2 into 2a, 4a plus 2 into 2n minus 1. So, 2 into 2n will be equal to 4n. 2 into minus 1 will be equal to minus 2 into d. I multiplied it by 2. Here, n by 2 taken common, minus sign is there. So, minus sign will come, minus 1 into 2a. So, that will be equal to minus 2a. And here, minus into plus will be equal to minus. Inside the bracket, we have n minus 1 into d. Now, we'll simplify it. 3 into n by 2, 4a. Minus 2a. So, that will be equal to 2a plus. Here d is common. So, that we will take outside. Afterwards, I will write. Remaining what will come inside the bracket. 4n minus 2. Minus sign will get multiplied. So, we will get minus n plus 1 into d. So, we are getting here 3n by 2 into 2a plus 4n minus n. 3n minus 2 plus 1 minus 1 into D. So we got 3n by 2 into 2a plus 3n minus 1 into D. Just to check what we wrote, S3 is equal to, this is the thing only we wrote. So just write down, this is equal to S3, which is equal to our left hand side. So we proved RHS is equal to LHS. So hope the method is clear to you. Okay, so moving on to the next question. Now next, in question number 3, it is given, if in an AP, sum of M terms is N. What is given? Sum of M terms is N. Sum of M terms. So SM is equal to N is given, and sum of N terms is M. Sum of N terms is equal to M is given. We have to prove sum of M plus N terms. So using these two information, first we can calculate what will be the value of A and D. So first one, SM is equal to N. According to the formula, what will come? SM is equal to M by 2 into 2A plus M minus 1 into D is equal to N. And next one, SN is equal to given. So what will come? N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D is equal to N. Now what we have to do? We have to do the subtraction. So before doing the subtraction, this expression shall be shifted to right hand side. Then calculation will be easy for you. So I am shifting the expression to right hand side. Only these two. This one we can multiply it inside there. So the first one will be equal to 2am plus m square minus m into d is equal to 2n. Here shifted. And same here also, these two I will shift to right hand side. So here we will get 2an plus n square minus n into d is equal to 2m. Now what we will do? We will do the subtraction. Minus, minus, minus. Here nothing will get cancelled here. What we will get? 2a. 2a common. Inside the bracket what will come? M minus m. Here plus d we can take common. Inside the bracket what will come? M square minus m. Minus sign will get multiplied. Minus n square minus into minus plus n is equal to, here 2n minus 2m. Now we can check how we can rearrange the term there. 2a into m minus n already there plus here we will check d into, now we are here we are rearranging m square minus n square can be written as m plus n into m minus n. M square minus n square I wrote it as m plus n into m minus n. And here minus sign if we will take common from these two, then inside the bracket m minus n only will come. So minus sign taken common, inside the bracket m minus n is equal to, here we have m minus n, in this term we have m minus n, here also we have m minus n, here m minus n we will get if we will take minus 2 common, then inside the it will be equal to m minus n. Now what we have? We have m minus n in all the terms. Then what we will do? We will divide it by m minus n. Dividing by m minus n. The whole equation. So the first term divided by m minus n. So it will get cancelled. Remaining it will be equal to 2a plus d into. Here m minus n will get cancelled. Remaining it will be equal to m plus n. Here m minus n will get cancelled. Remaining it will be equal to 1. And here also m minus n will get cancelled. Remaining will be equal to 2. 2. So these are the information which we got from the given information. Now we will check whether we will get the proof or not. We have to find the sum of m plus n terms. Means what we want? SMN. So according to the formula, how we will write? M plus n by 2 into 2a plus m plus n minus 1 into d. Now just to check the previous step, we wrote 2a plus m plus n minus 1 into d is equal to how much? Minus 2. So in place of whole, what we can substitute? Minus 2. So we will get m plus n by 2 into minus 2. So 2 and 2 will get cancelled. We will get minus of m plus n. So this type of question requires a lot of practice. You yourself also do it one more time and check whether you are getting the solution or not. Clear? Yes. So moving on to the next question. Then next question, it is written, if the sum of m terms of an AP is same as the sum of its n terms. Okay. Sum of m terms meaning SM is same as means is equal to sum of n terms. And then we have to prove its m plus n terms is 0. So first we can simplify it. So again we'll use the formula SM is equal to m by 2 into 2a plus m minus 1 into d is equal to SN. Here n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So first what we did? We used the concept sum of n terms is equal to sum of n terms. That was the information given. Then we have used the formula. So we can check here 2 and 2 will get cancelled there. Remaining m I am multiplying inside. So here it will be equal to 2am plus m square minus m into d is equal to right hand side 2an plus n square minus n into d. Now what we will do? We will shift all the expression to one side. So I am writing the coefficient of 2a together. 2am minus 2an plus d, I am taking common, m square minus m. When we will shift here, negative sign will come. So negative sign will get multiplied inside. So it will become minus n square minus into minus plus into d is equal to 0. Now as we wrote in the previous one, we'll take the common factors outside 2a. Inside the bracket what will remain? M minus n. Here again m square minus n square can be written as m plus n into m minus n. Here m minus n is there. Here also we have m minus n. But here we have minus m plus n. So we want a negative sign common. So I am taking a negative sign common from these two terms. So we will get m minus n into d is equal to 0. So as we did in the previous one, dividing by m minus n. So dividing whole equation. So this will get cancelled. Remaining it will be equal to 2a plus here m minus n will get cancelled. Remaining m plus n. Here m minus n will get cancelled. Remaining will be equal to 1. Into d is equal to 0 divided by anything will be equal to 0. So we got 2a plus m plus n minus 1 into d is equal to 0. Now we have to find out sum of m plus n terms. So s m plus n we want. According to the formula it will be equal to m plus n by 2 into 2a plus m plus n minus 1 into d. Just to check, 2a plus m plus n minus 1 into d is equal to what we wrote? 0. So in place of this, what we can substitute? It is equal to 0. So n plus n by 2 multiplied by 0, that will come equal to 0. So hope now this method you are getting clear. Yes, okay. So moving on to the next question. Now in the next question it is written the ratio of sum of n terms of 2 APs. 2 APs are given. So we'll take the AP, the first term of the first AP as A1 and common difference as D1. And just you can write down there for first AP, this is the first term. So first term, and this is the common difference for the first AP. Common difference for the first AP. And for the second AP, we will take the first term as A2 and common difference as D2. Because in the question it was given the ratio of sum of n terms of 2 APs. So 2 different APs are there. Their ratio is given 7n plus 1 by is to 4n plus 20. Now directly we will write in terms of ratio. Sum of n terms of the first AP I am writing. So n by 2 into, this is the first term. So 2a1 plus n minus 1 into d1 by, for the second one, sum of n terms, n by 2 into 2a2 plus n minus 1 into d2 is equal to, what is given in the question? 7n plus 1 by 4n plus 20. This is the information which is given. Clear how I wrote there? Sum of n terms of 2 APs are given in this ratio. Now here n by 2 and n by 2 will get cancelled. What we have to find out? We have to find the ratio of their 12th term. So somewhere write down. We want the ratio of their 12th term, meaning if you will check the first one. 12th term, so A1 plus 11D1 by A2 plus 11D2 we want. So this is the information we want. At present we have this one. So here just to check the information which we want in that 2A1 is not there. What is there? Only A1 is there. So to get A1 what we have to do? We'll divide both numerator and denominator by 2. Just write down dividing numerator and denominator by 2. So when we will divide, it will divide it by both the terms there. So it will be equal to now 2a1 divided by 2. So we will get a1 plus. This expression also will get divided by 2. By a2 plus n minus 1 by 2 into D2 is equal to 7n plus 1 by 4n plus 20. So the first term we got, that is A1. Now just to check what we want the next one. 11 we want. Coefficient of D1 should be equal to 11. At present we have coefficient of D1 as n minus 1 by 2. So here somewhere we will write n minus 1 by 2 should be equal to 11. Why I wrote equal to 11? Because I want the ratio of 12th term. Here value of n minus 1 by 2 we will change accordingly which term we want there. Okay, so this one will come according to the term which we want there. If we have to find the ratio of 20th term, then here it will be equal to a1 plus 19D1. So here we will write n minus 1 by 2 is equal to 19. So from here we will check what will be the value of n. 2 will go there. So 2 into 11, 22 plus 1. So n should be equal to 23. So now what we will do? We are going to substitute n is equal to 23. So a1 plus n minus 1 by 2 already we wrote, we have taken is equal to 11. 11D1 by A2 plus 11D2 is equal to, in the right hand side, in place of N, we will substitute 23. So it will be equal to 7 into 23 plus 1 by 4 into 23 plus 20. Now we'll simplify this one. Here we got the ratio of 12th term. So 7 into 23. 7 threes are 21. Carry over to 7 twos are 14 plus 2, 16 plus 1 by 4 threes are 12. Carry over 1. 4 twos are 8 plus 1, 9 plus 20. So 161 plus 1 will be equal to 162 by 92 plus 20 will be equal to 112. Just to check whether it is divisible by 2. So we can cancel it by 2. 81, and here it will come 2 5s are 2 6s. So we will get 81 by 56. So again, just to go through it there. And here the value which I wrote, it will depend on which term we have to calculate there. Clear? Okay. So we'll move to the last question. Now next is the ratio of sums of m and n terms of an AP. In the previous question, it was given of two APs, and here the ratio of sum of m and n terms of an AP. So we don't want A1 and D1, we will take it as A and D. So ratio of sum of m terms of an AP. So m terms of an AP, that is m by 2 into 2a plus m minus 1 into d by n terms, that is n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d is equal to what is given? M square by n square. M square by n square. So you can check there, 2 and 2 will get cancelled there. M and n we are shifting to right hand side. N at present here it is in denominator. When you will change the position, it will go to numerator, and n will go to denominator. So remaining here 2a plus m minus 1 into d by 2a plus n minus 1 into d is equal to m square by n square into n by n. So 1m and 1n will get cancelled. So remaining here it will be equal to 2a plus m minus 1 into d by 2a plus n minus 1 into d is equal to m by n. At present we haven't got anything, then what we should do? Yes, we will do the cross multiplication. So we will get here 2an plus m minus 1 into d multiplied by n. So it will be equal to mn minus n multiplied by d is equal to right hand side 2am plus n minus 1 multiplied by m. So it will be equal to mn minus m into d. So we'll shift all the expression to one side, or 2a we can shift to one side. So 2an minus 2am is equal to d into, this I have shifted here. So this expression I am shifting to right hand side and taking the common. So mn minus m minus mn minus will become plus n. When we will change the position, it will become negative there. So that's why I have changed the sign. So here we will get 2a common. Inside the bracket what will come? N minus m. And here if anything will get cancelled, mn, n minus mn will get cancelled. And here also we are getting d is equal to n minus m. So we can divide the whole equation by n minus m. So what will remain? 2a is equal to d. So we got a is equal to d is equal to 2a. So somewhere I am writing we got d is equal to 2a. Method is clear till here? Okay. So now we will check what we have to find out. We have to show the ratio of mth and nth term. we want the ratio of their term, meaning what we want, am by an. We want the ratio of am by an. Am, according to the formula, a plus m minus 1 into d by an, a plus n minus 1 into d. And from this equation we got d is equal to 2a. So in place of d, I am going to substitute 2a. So we'll get a plus m minus 1 into 2a by a plus n minus 1 into 2a. We'll simplify it. So we'll get a plus 2am minus 2a by a plus 2a will be multiplied. So 2an minus 2a. A minus 2a will be equal to minus a. So we will get 2am minus a by here 2an minus a. Anything common here? A. Taken outside. Then inside the bracket what will come? 2m minus 1 by here a is common, taken outside. So 2n minus 1. So these two will get cancelled. We will get the ratio of mth term and nth term as 2m minus 1 by 2n minus 1. So hope these type of questions are clear to you. I'll send some these type of questions as homework. So do the homework and just ask if any doubt is there. Thank you.